tie a sulfur emerger or other mayfly emergers. First thing I'm going to do is lay down a base of yellow thread, come back over top the tagline, go back to about where the bend really starts on this pupa hook. I like using a pupa style hook when tying emergers. Next thing I'm going to do is come up back up front here and stop about two-thirds of the way up. I'm going to take a puff at its natural separation and just pull it, not apart, but just separate it. And you can see the rubber ball right here. I'm going to take that rubber ball and put it where my thread stopped. And I'm going to come up, grab the thread between my index finger and thumb, and then come down real tight over top of that. And I'm going to do 3, 4, 5 good, real tight wraps there. Now, once I've accomplished that, what I want to do now is create the trailing shuck. And by doing that, I just come back here over top the wing material and then come back forward again. And I'm just going to go back and forth till I get a good solid base of yellow color there. I'm not a big fan of dubbing on smaller flies like 16s and 18s. I prefer just using thread and then building it up. Then what I want to do up here to finish this off to make it look like an emerger is take some spikier dubbing, goldish brown in color with a little flash to it, pull some off, throw it on the thread fairly loose, and then I want to go behind the wing material where the rubber ball is, finish that off, pull that back, come forward, and then just finish off the eye. And I'm going to do a good 20 wraps there. Once I've done that, I want to whip finish it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 at least. And then after that, trim off the thread and throw down some head cement to finish that off. Now, what you can see, I got the wing and I got the trailing shuck. You can see this is fairly tight, and that's because maybe there's a fiber in there that's holding it together. Just take your scissors and go up through it, and you can see how it puffs out then. What you can do is trim that off to the look you want. I prefer leaving it long, and I can always trim it on the stream. Same with the shuck. I can come back here, trim off the shuck, trim off some material if I feel there's too much there. So there's different things you can do with it. That's a pretty basic, pretty quick and fast, easy way to tie a sulfur emerger. There's only 4 materials being used to tie that.